Hello guys, welcome back to the second part of this series, and in this video we will cover the remaining CSS and we will also set up this slider that we have on our landing page. So this is where we left off in the first video. So now let me just quickly open my project. So I need to make a few more adjustments into my index.html. So first thing is to make sure that this link for main.css is after this glide.co.main.css. And one more thing, one thing that I forgot to add in the first video was just before this closing tag of this section, we need one more div. And so let me just copy the code here. So this div will have a class name of background, and basically we will use this div in our JavaScript to for our animation, background animation that we have on the landing page. Now coming to my CSS file, I have opened my main.css here. So first thing that I need to add is some basic styling for all the elements. So for all elements, we'll have a padding and margin of 0, and font family that I will be using is Poppins. So for body, I am giving this width and height of 100 viewport width and 100 viewport height, and everything that is overflowing will be hidden. Next thing that we have is the background. So for the background, I am setting position absolute width and height of 100%, and for now I am giving this one a background color. So this will be changed, or I should say this will be removed once we start writing JavaScript. The z index will be -1, so it remains in the backmost layer. Then we have for the image itself in the background, the height and width is set to 100%. So now the next thing that we have is our nav. So for nav, I'm giving display of flex, some paddings, the color is set to white, and then justify content space between and aligning everything to the center. Next thing that we have is for the logo that we have. So for the h5, I'm simply giving this one a font size and a cursor of pointer. Next thing that we have is the unordered list and the list item. So for the unordered list, the list style is set to none. And for the list item, I'm setting display to inline block and some margin and then some font size. Next thing that we have in the nav is this div with a class name of search. So this will basically hold the search icon. So for this div, I will simply give this one a width and height of 30 pixel and then border radius of 50% to make it a circle. And then background color of white, and then display flex and justify everything to the center. Now for the icon itself, I give this one a color gray and a font size of 12. So now the nav should be looking proper. As you can see, the navigation is complete. Now we need to add styling for the side indicator that we have. So for this one, 1, 2, 3, 4 that we see here, it should look like this. So let me get back to my CSS file. So inside this, I will copy the code for my side indicator. So this one will have a height of 70%, from top setting it to 15%, left 0, and a width of 350 pixel, and position is absolute, and flex direction is column. Now for inside this side indicator, first we have this div with a class name of line, then we have the 4 index. So for the line, it will be straightforward. Width will be 1 pixel and then height is 100%. Background color is this slight grayish color and the opacity is set to 0. Now after the line, we have the index itself. So for the index, I am giving this one a height and width of 10 pixel and a border radius of 50%. And then this transition property, height 0.7 second, ease width 0.7 second ease. So this will basically add a smooth transition animation when we move to the active one. So right now you cannot see this. So basically what will happen is the active index will have a greater width and height, and the transition between the less height to more height will have a smooth animation. So now this, I'm adding this active tag for the active class. Height and width is setting to 30 pixel, and for the text that we have in the index, initially the opacity will be 0, but for the active one, the opacity will be set to 1. So opacity 1, and also increasing the font size to 16 pixel. So you can see, let me just add one active here and save this one. So you can see now the active one will have this styling and the inactive will be smaller circles. Now we are done with this indicator stuff. So the next thing that we have is the content itself. So let me just remove this active class, and after that I will add the CSS for my content. For the content, position will be set to absolute from top 0 and width and height of 100%, and then some flex properties. Now inside this content we will have two things: the text wrapper. So for the text wrapper, I'm setting the width to 60%, and then we have the slider. So for that, the class name is glide. So I will just copy the code for glide here. So the glide will have a width of 40%. So this will take 60% and this will take 40% of the screen. So let me just show you. So as you can see, this is taking 60% and this is taking 40%. Now let's add some more styling for our text wrapper. So inside this text wrapper, what we have is this text class, which will actually hold the title and the description. So for that, let me just bring the code here. So for text, I'm giving this one padding left 300 pixel and padding right 100 pixel. So now let's add some styling for the title and the description. So as mentioned in the previous video, only one title and one description will be shown at a time. So as you can see, inside the text we have this div with an ID of title, and inside this we have the h4 tag. So what I will do is create a container with a fixed height. So for this title, overflow is set to hidden and height is set to 150 pixel, and then display flex, flex direction, column and some margin. So what this will do basically is create a 150 pixels container. So right now the text size is small, so we are able to see all four text. Let me just add a background color so it is more clear to you. So this is the container for the title, and now inside the title what I will do is increase the font size for the h4 tag that we have. So I'm increasing the font size to 120 pixel and then giving this one a font family of Oswald, and position is set to relative. So now only one will be visible at a time, and the rest of them are below this, but they are not visible because we have this overflow of hidden on this title ID. Now the next similar thing will happen for the description as well. So for the description, I'm also giving this one a fixed height of 55 pixel, and overflow is set to hidden. Let me also give this one a background color so it is more clear to you. So as you can see, this will hold the description, and only one description should be shown at a time. So for that, the text that we have inside the description, let me just add it here. So as you can see, the font size is set to 12 pixel and max height I'm setting to 55 pixel. So now only one will be visible at a time. And what will happen is, in our JavaScript, when we click on the next button, we will translate this title and the text by this height, so that the next will be visible and the current will move to the top, so it will not be visible. Now the next thing is the button itself. So nothing special here, just a width of 150 pixel and giving this one a background color, and then some proper padding, margins and stuff, and then for the text, proper font size and color. So now as you can see, this is complete. So we are done with this text section. So let me remove this background color. Let me just leave it here. I will remove it in the next video when we will start writing the JavaScript part. So now the next thing that we have is for the slider. So for the slider, we have already given this one a width of 40%. The next thing is this. After this, we have this glide cover. So this will basically cover the slider. So the user will not be able to drag the slides, but the slide should be changed only by clicking on the previous or the next button. So for this glide cover, I am setting this width of height of 100% and setting z index to 1, so it will be on top of the slides, so the user will not be able to drag the slides. Now the next thing, we don't need to add style for the glide track. We need to add the styling for the slides itself. So for the slide, let me just bring the code here. So height and width will be 500 pixel and 250 pixel, display flex, flex direction column, and then margin right of 40 pixel. And then what we have is the image inside the slide. So for the slider image, we am setting this on a height of 300 pixel, and then border radius is 10 pixel, and then overflow to hidden. So this will make this one a rectangle with a border radius of 10 pixel. And for the active one, the height will be 400 pixels. So only one slide will be active at a time. That is, that will have a greater height. So for the inactive one, we'll have a 300 pixel height, and the active one will have a height of 400 pixel. Now for the image itself, width and height of 100%, and object fit is set to cover. So now you can see we are able to see the first slide. Now we also need to add styling for the text that we have for slides. Then we also have this rating. So let me bring the code for that here. The first thing is for the text itself. So for the text, color is white and font size is setting to 14 pixel. And then we have this rating. So rating will have a width of 60 pixel, padding of 8 pixel and 0, and justify content to space between. So let me just explain you, this is the rating. As you can see, there are five circles, and four of them are having a greater opacity, so it acts like we have the rating of 4 by 5. So for the circle, I am giving this one a width and height of 7 pixel, and opacity is set to 0.5 for the circle. And for the active one, I will increase the opacity. So active will have an opacity of 1. So this will give us a view. As you can see, it seems like we have a rating of 4 by 5. Next thing is we have a bookmark icon on each of these slides. So for that, I will just quickly bring the code here. So for the bookmark, position is absolute, and then some adjustment of top right so that it is at its proper position, and then width and height of 40 pixel. So as you can see, this looks fine. Now the next thing we have to adjust is for the CSS for the control buttons. So for the controls, I am giving this one a width of 80 pixel, display flag, justify content of space between, and position relative. So let me just show you what is this control. So for we have this controls class, inside this we have this two div. So one is for the previous button, and the next one is for the next button. So this controls class will act as a container for the two buttons. Now for the div itself, I am giving this one a width and height of 30 pixel and border radius 50%. So for these two div, and then background color is set to white, and then some display flex property. And setting this transition all 0.5 second, because when the user clicks on the button, we want to show a little animation, and that is we will scale down to 0.6. So when the user clicks on it, the button size will be reduced. Now for the icon, I'm giving this one gray color. So as you can see, when we click, we have this small animation. Now the next thing is to show the remaining slides. So for that, we will need to add some JavaScript code. So let me just quickly open my JavaScript file, and inside this I will create an event on the document itself, and once the event is triggered, this function will be called. So let me also create this function. I'm creating an arrow function here, and the event will be DOM content loaded. So basically, when everything is loaded, then only we want to run our whatever we want to run. So once this DOM content is loaded, then the code inside this function will be executed. So inside this, I am initializing my glide class. So this takes as parameter, this first one will be .glide, which is our glide class. Type will be carousel, start at 0. And then animation timing function, gap is 100, and per view is 3. Per view 3 means only 3 slides will be shown to the user at a time. So now as you can see, when we click on the next button, we have this animation. So as you can also see, the image height is increasing for the active one. This one has 300 and the active one has a height of 400 pixel. So that's all we need to add for initializing our glide class. Now while we are at it, let me also add some more CSS so that our landing page is responsive. So the first thing is for the breakpoint of 1600 pixel, I have added this media query. So what I am doing is basically reducing everything. So for this text, I am reducing the font size, And for the other stuff, I'm reducing the width. So nothing special here. The next thing is for another breakpoint, I'm adding for 1300 pixel. So again, reducing the size of the text, and for the nav, I'm reducing the padding. For the slide, I'm reducing the height and width. So now let me show you. So as you can see, when we reduce the width, this text size is reduced. And one more breakpoint is here. So after this, I will also add another breakpoint, because now as you can see, the text are getting hidden. So the next media query will be at this width at 1200 pixel. So let me just bring the code here. So for 1200 pixel, I am again reducing the width of the side indicator, reducing that padding. Now the most important thing is for the content. Now I'm setting the flex direction to column. So previously by default it is set to row, and now also I'm increasing the width to 100% for both the text wrapper and the glide, and the rest is just reducing the height and width. So now what will happen when we reduce it further? As you can see, now the flex direction is column. So on the top we will have the text, and on the bottom we will have the slider. Now for this navigation bar, you can add some more CSS like a hamburger menu or another thing. So I'm not gonna do that here in this video. So that's all CSS that we need. So in the next video, we will cover the remaining animation for the text animation, the background animation, and also for the side indicator. So I hope you guys will like this video. And if you like this video, then please give this video a thumbs up. And also don't forget to subscribe to the channel, and I will see you in the next one. Thank you.